Hi everyone, you might have seen my introduction earlier in the welcome kind of part of today. However, if you didn't, my name's Molly. I'm a recent graduate having studied at Teddy Hall from 2016 to 2019. I'm here to give you some tips and advice about the application process from a student perspective. So I hope you enjoy. So first up, we have personal statements. A personal statement is something that you will have to write whatever British university you apply to. So it's not necessarily an Oxford specific part of the application. However, I thought it would be valuable if you guys got an idea about what sort of things you can write about. So in this 500 word essay, as it were, you basically have to demonstrate to the tutor or to the person reading your personal statement that you are set on reading geography at university, and you have to demonstrate why that is the case. By no means do you have to have the most amazing kind of backlog of things that you've been up to that are related to geography. I personally didn't have any work experience in geography other than providing tutorial assistance at a local middle school, but it just needs to show that you really enjoy geography as a subject and that you want to continue learning about it. Speaking from personal experience, I wrote about a book that I had read about natural hazards in the developing world. I also spoke about an online course that I pursued in climate change and how that kind of affirmed that geography at university level was for me. And I also spoke about my other A-level subjects. So I did history, English literature, geography, and then maths at AS level. And I spoke about how these subjects, whilst not very clearly linked to geography, helped me reinforce and enhance my geographical line of thinking. But importantly, there is absolutely no formula to making the perfect personal statement. I've read many personal statements, all of which were very different, but equally successful in portraying the message that geography is what they want to pursue at university. So it's very important to kind of not get too het up in reading thousands of books or attending countless speaker events. It just has to demonstrate that you have a real, genuine interest in the subject to which you're applying. Now, something that is a bit more Oxbridge specific is the college system. The college system is something from the outset that seems quite daunting. However, you soon come to learn that it's very much not the case and actually aids the kind of academic experience here. A lot of people think that by putting down a college preference, it's going to make it look like you've done more research and therefore are more likely to get an interview. I can confirm that that's mere urban myths because you are not at any hindrance if you do not put a college preference in your application. So if you like a college and decide that that's where you want to apply, feel free to do so. But if you don't have college preference, do not put one down. It does not matter whatsoever. Importantly, the academic experience you receive at Oxford will be exactly the same regardless of what college you attend. I applied to Jesus for no other reason than I liked their spaghetti carbonara on an open day, and from interview onwards I was moved to Teddy Hall and absolutely loved it there. I've never met someone that doesn't love the college that they go to. So I think the main part of this is do not be concerned about choosing a college, and also don't get too kind of invested in a college, because there is a chance that you could be moved either prior to interview or after interview. The main difference between colleges are primarily things like accommodation, food, proximity to the city centre, number of students that will study alongside you. So for example, if you want to live in all 3 years, you should perhaps spend more time looking at colleges that provide this. But as regarding choosing a college for the application process, it's really not something to get stressed about. So last, but by no means least, we have interviews. So interviews, at least in the field of geography, is quite a unique thing to Oxford. But dare I say it, they're actually very interesting and actually quite insightful and fun. They replicate quite similarly what a tutorial is like, i.e. you have tutors sitting there asking you questions, often asking you to kind of think on your feet in some way or another. Often in an interview, we provided a resource or a material that you're asked to discuss and analyse, whether this be a news article, an image, a diagram, or a graph. The key piece of advice I can give here is to not go in with things that you plan on saying or pre-planned phrases or speeches, because tutors can see through that very easily. The tutors want to see you think on your feet, and the best way of doing that is going in with an open mind, trying to kind of be well read on what's happening in the current state of affairs. That should be fairly easy to do if you're a geographer, because you hopefully should be engaged with what's happening around you. Finally, and I think this is the most kind of important part of this, is try not to be too nervous, because the tutors aren't there to catch you out and to try and make you say something wrong. They do just genuinely want to see your thought process. They're not looking for a robotic student who knows everything. After all, if you knew everything, then you wouldn't need to go to university to learn more. They're just looking for someone who really engages with geography as a discipline and who they think will benefit from the tutorial system. So that's my advice regarding applying to Oxford. If you're sitting here watching this video with a good set of grades and you like the course at Oxford, I really strongly encourage you to apply, even if you think it's on a whim. Back in 2015, when I was looking, I would have absolutely no idea that I'd be sitting here today speaking to future prospective students. So who knows, chuck yourself an application in and you could be where I am today. So thank you very much for listening, and I hope you found all of the resources today incredibly useful, and don't hesitate to get in contact with people from the department if you do have any further questions. Thank you. Bye.